Hi everyone, this is James from onlinegeckos.com. Today I'm going to show you our gecko room and give you a walkthrough so you can see our setup and our equipment. As you know, we're a small scale hobbyist breeder. We're pretty much a hobbyist first, breeder second. So that's why we have so many tanks set up. I know it's more of an unconventional setup for breeders, but because we're small scale, we're able to set up tanks, and these tanks allow us to enjoy our geckos better. They remind us of why we got into this hobby in the first place and why we started breeding in the first place. Now the rack systems, they're perfectly reasonable. They make sense for people that want to breed a lot of geckos because they're cost effective. They save a lot of space and they're efficient. So there's nothing wrong with rack systems. It's just for us, because we're small scale, we're able to do these tanks, and we'll kind of do half of the tanks and half of a rack system, kind of split them on half and half. So anyways, we have about 16 of these 20-gallon tanks. They're all set up on these shelving system that we got from Kmart. They cost about $27 each for these shelving systems, and they actually work very well. As you can see, there's three shelves, so you can stack three tanks and they fit perfectly pretty much. And now if you're a hobbyist, you got one or two geckos, you're looking to get more tanks, you're looking to expand, the shelving system will work pretty well for you. They'll allow you to stack these tanks up one on top of each other, and it saves you a lot of room. You don't have to go find more table space or more cabinet space. So pretty much you'll see in all these tanks, we use ceramic tiles in them. They're standard 12 by 12 tiles, and they fit these fitting these 20-gallon tanks perfectly. These are standard 30 by 12 by 12 20-gallon long tanks. And we choose tiles because it's clean, and there's no impaction risk for your geckos, and pretty much the geckos like them. And they look pretty good. But pretty much we just want to make sure that there's no impaction risk for the geckos. That's very important. When you use loose substrate like sand, you always have to worry about maybe your geckos impacted or not. Whenever your gecko stops eating, that's one of the things that you worry about. We just don't want to have that risk at all. And in each one of these tanks, you'll see that there's a warm hide, moist hide, and cool hide, and plenty of water and space for them to roam around. So it's pretty much a standard setup for us. And moving on, right here we have a couple folding tables. Got them from Target. They work very well because if you ever need a space or room, you can just fold them up, put them away. But we use these tables for feeding, sometimes for packaging. We also use these tables when we need to weigh the geckos and take pictures. And here we have all the feeding supplies that we need, our feeders. And right here, we have our boafile plastics rack system. On the left, these are the hatchling rack. There's about 50 of them. They use the standard shoebox size bins. And this is basically our standard setup for hatchling racks. You know, we use paper towel as a substrate, and we give them a moist hide, use wet paper towels. And the toilet paper roll is perfect because it's light, so it won't hurt them if they roll them over or if they tip them over. It's perfect for hatchlings. And you got the mealworm dish, and you got the water, and you got calcium. And this is one of our banded hatchlings. She is very curious. And here's another and the hatchling. It's got about the same setup as the other one. So now each breeders will label these geckos differently for us. Very simply, we're putting the morph bandit, temperature sex female, and the skew number, which from this skew number we can actually tell exactly which male. M6 will tell us exactly which male it is. F14 will tell us which female we used. So these will be the parents. And 05/29/13, that's the hatch date. And F stands for female. Okay, and over here to the right we have our larger racks. They're using the 15 quarts Rubbermaid bins. They're actually wider than the standard Sterilite bins, so they give them plenty of space. So we keep them in the hatching bins for usually 2 to 3 months until they're about 20 to 30 grams. Then we transfer them over to the other side. And with these, the setup is pretty similar really. We use obviously a bigger container. This is a moist hide with cocoa fiber. So females use these as a moist hide as well as a lay box. They work very well. And this gecko back here is our total eclipse. Super snow eclipse. Beautiful gecko. Love the white tail tip and the white feet. She recently laid a couple clutches for us, so we're waiting for the hatchlings. Let's see. And this one is our female radar. Beautiful gecko. Radar is a Bell albino eclipse. I just woke her up. Alright, and over here we have our incubators. On the right is the Nature Spirits incubator. Currently incubating for females. We usually incubate more females than male. That's why the larger one is being used for the females. On the left, it's a Repti Pro 6000. It's a mini fridge style. And we got a couple cups in there for the male incubation. So these are Nature Spirit incubator. They work very, very well. Very spacious, as you can see, and we do use the geo cups. They're really great at separating the eggs. And of course you got Herbstat Spider Robotics Herbstat hooked up to the incubator. It's a great thermostat to use. So that's pretty much it. This is our gecko room, and nothing too fancy, but they work very well for us and they keep us going with this hobby and breeding. So if you have any questions, please let us know. You can email us info@onlinegeckos.com. We hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you. Bye.